Rhythm is fundamental to calligraphy, more so today than ever before. Some artists value it more than legibility. But in traditional work as well as wild expressionism, a good rhythmic run is valued highly. This aspect is often elusive and deserves special discussion. Rhythm is defined as a pattern of repetition, and any regular recurrence can be seen as rhythmic. Our patterns of behavior, based on the time we get up in the morning, and our daily, weekly, and seasonal routines, form a rhythm based ultimately on the movements of the Earth. The integrated symphony of movement of the entire solar system is a compelling and beautiful example of rhythm. And rhythm in writing is fundamental. Even perfect letter forms are lifeless without it. In fact, rhythm applies to calligraphy in two distinct ways that initially seem diametrically opposed, since one involves a left-brained mental process and the other is inherently right-brained in its activity. If I place my hands here and here, my left hand represents the rhythm of repeating structure in writing. The regular recurrence of related forms within any style lead to this structural rhythm, combined with the regular spacing between the forms. This aspect of rhythm in writing is a logical left-brained process that must be learned by careful and well-informed practice. On the other hand is the rhythm of fluency. Fluency means flowing and comes from writing directly, unself-consciously, and without premeditation. It should be as natural as water flowing downhill. Just as a different terrain will change the flow of a stream, various scripts, tools, and personalities will each yield differing types of fluency in writing. If structural rhythm derives from the regular recurrence of related shapes, fluency derives more from a regular repetition of gestures. Of course, these two aspects of rhythm are interdependent. The former derives from the latter. Calligraphy can thus be considered a recording in ink of a performance of movements. However, the two aspects of rhythm, structure and fluency, remain diametrically opposed for students. Concentration on structural rhythm, getting well-related letter shapes and spacing, tends to make you lose sight of the fluency aspect and the writing appears stiff, while trying to be more fluent will make you lose sight of structural aspects and the writing appears messy. Nonetheless, it's worth practicing both aspects in separate exercises. Don't always concentrate on the letter shapes. Occasionally practice with a focus on developing fluency. Try writing a little bit faster, with less premeditation, and perhaps a richer ink flow resulting from loading the pen more fully. The results may be less neat, but it can be great fun. It's likely that your everyday personal handwriting is your most fluent and individual writing, since it is performed naturally, without self-consciousness. If you can unite some of this aspect with more structured calligraphy, your writing will benefit greatly. It's only by continual practice over years that these two aspects of rhythm in calligraphy, structural rhythm and fluency, can be gradually brought from here to here. Looking towards one no longer excludes the other for the true master. Yin and yang have been perfectly integrated to make a whole much greater than the sum of the parts. This ideal is rarely achieved in the world of calligraphy, but comes only from repeated and well-informed practice over years. Eventually, the lessons of structural shape become learned to the degree that they are knowledge, and applying them is no effort. The master does not need to think about formal aspects because he knows them. He is thus free to be aware of subtleties of ink flow and dynamics of expression. This is what freedom means in calligraphy, and it results in writing with a life of its own that expresses the personality of the writer. Freedom means knowing the rules so well that they can be discarded without compromise. At this stage, writing is not working, but playing. And like a virtuoso soloist, the master penman plays with dynamics and expression, improvising at every moment within a prearranged score.